Good evening and a very warm welcome from the Royal Opera House, both to our audience here in the Claw Studio and to all of you watching around the world. I'm Tamsin Roberts and I'm delighted to bring you tonight's Insight, where we'll be delving behind the scenes of Swan Lake, one of the world's most loved ballets. Well, opening here in Covent Garden this spring and then returning in the summer, Swan Lake is a tale of love, treachery and forgiveness. Set to Tchaikovsky's sensational score, Swan Lake really is a feast for the senses. With choreography by Liam Scarlett and designs by John McFarlane, breathtaking corps de ballet sequences and one of the most challenging solos of the repertory. Well, surrounding the central love story is a rich assembly of family and guests at court and swans, of course, at the lakeside, some of which we're going to see tonight. How wonderful. But first, for our first rehearsal, please do join me in welcoming dancers of the Royal Ballet, Leo Dixon and Teo de Broglie, and guest repetiteur, Samira Saidi. Thank you. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. Lovely to see you all. I know it's been an extremely busy time for you all, what with a festival of new choreography, the run of Manon still going on, so thank you very much for joining us tonight. Now we're on to Swan Lake. Sammy, to you first, how are rehearsals going? Where are you in the rehearsal progress?
Well, we had our first full call today in the studio. As always with the Royal Ballet, we always feel like we never have enough time to rehearse. But I have to say the full call was looking pretty good this afternoon. So I think we're in the sort of place we need to be for everyone to feel confident that we're going in the right direction.
So just tweaking now, is it?
Tweaking, and we've still got lots of rehearsal to do, lots of stage calls coming up. And of course, we've got many, many new casts going on in lots of different roles.
That's exciting. Now, you're both making your debut as Benno, right?
Yeah.
Very exciting. Congratulations to you both. Tell us a bit about how rehearsals are going, because there's quite a lot of dancing in this role, Siegfried's friend, isn't there? To you first, Teo, how have rehearsals been going? Are you enjoying taking on this role?
Yeah, it's great. I mean, me personally, I haven't had any proper rehearsals for Benno yet. My shows are a bit later on in the run. So we've had the learning calls, but I haven't really broken it down yet and properly got in. So this will be my first one.
Oh, right. Okay. Oh, it's a treat for us then to see that. Fantastic. And how about you, Leah? How are you enjoying the journey of Benno so far?
Yeah, it's been going well for me. I'm a little bit further ahead than Teo because I think my shows are earlier. So I've been kind of running things a bit this week with my two sisters. And it's been going well. Yeah, it's been a challenge for sure, because there's a lot of dancing, as you said, but it's been good to kind of get the ball rolling with it and see how it's going to feel.
And how challenging is the role and the choreography here? I mean, we do know Swan Lake is notoriously hard. Is this a difficult
yes.
role to take on? Honest, we
yes.
like that, honest.
It's difficult technically. It's a very classical ballet, so your technique has to be on point, but also stamina. The pas de trois in acts 1 and 3 is a real cardio workout. So you've got to build up your stamina before you get to even stepping on stage. So I'd say that's having the balance of the two, the really strong technique and the stamina together is what's most important.
You face the same challenges there, would you say, Leo?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. I think it's quite heavy on the jumps, especially in the first act. So it's about kind of building up to the strength that you need for, as Teo said, for the shows. But it's a good challenge, you know. We like to be challenged.
We can't wait to see some of that challenge tonight. That's brilliant. When you think about Swan Lake, Sammy, it's so iconic as a ballet, isn't it? It's that quintessential image of ballet that everybody has. Can you remember the first time that you saw Swan Lake and what impact that had on you?
Gosh, I can't honestly say I remember the first time I saw it. It just feels like it's been a part of my life, really, from when I started dancing at school. I went to watch Swan Lake. As a student, I got to be a swan in Swan Lake here at the Opera House. And then, of course, went on to dance in Peter Wright's wonderful production with Sadler's Wells Royal Ballet. And I was lucky enough to be a swan, a big swan, and eventually Odette Odile. So, you know, I went through the whole gamut, if you like, of Swan Lake. So it's very special to me.
Oh, well, we're definitely going to come back and talk more about that. That's really exciting. We'll delve into your experience in Swan Lake. And what about you guys? Can you remember the first time? Probably not that long ago, because you're both so young.
I don't know if I can remember the first time I saw Swan Lake, but I've been involved in, I think, three different productions of Swan Lake now. So I was with English National Ballet when I left school, so I was involved in Derek Dean's production. And then when I joined the Royal Ballet, we were still doing Anthony Dow's production, and now we have Liam Scarlett's production. And you find something new in each, even though it's the same ballet, you're finding something different through each choreographer's interpretation of the show, so that's really interesting. Mm.
Yeah, I don't think I can remember the first time either, but I think it's just one of those ballets that's, as Sammy said, it's kind of always part of a dancer's life in a classical company. And as you build your way through different roles, from a young dancer or a student being even just a footman at the back and watching star principals doing the lead roles, it's always exciting to be a part of.
I was going to say, how exciting is it to be taking on this role? It must be hugely exciting.
It is exciting. Nerve-wracking. It's a lot of responsibility. You know, you carry a decent chunk of the show, but that's why we do it.
Yeah. Exactly, and we can't wait to see rehearsals. Do you mind telling us what you're going to be rehearsing tonight, Sammy?
Yes, well, first of all, I want to say that we're not doing Act One, because Act One is really, everybody's familiar with the pas de trois from Act One, and it's generally done in most ballet companies with perhaps a few little tweaks here and there. So I thought it might be more interesting for the audience to see Act Three, which is specially created for this production. And we're going to show, we're going to sort of work through in sections the solo that Benno does in Act Three. And he has quite a meaty solo, really, with lots and lots of steps.
Yeah.
There are steps pretty much to every count of the music. And it's also quite stylized. So I think it'll be interesting to break it down and let the guys do it in small sections, because I don't want them to be too exhausted, because tomorrow we have another full call of Swan Lake in the studio, so we have to be careful of them.
Of course. Yeah. Well, we are very grateful to have you here tonight, and we can't wait to see your rehearsal. Thank you so much for chatting to us as well. Leo, Teo, Sammy, thank you very much. I'll leave it over to you, and also introduce Head of Music Rob Clark, who's playing for us this evening. Thank you very much.
Okay.
I just want to take your mics. Thank you.
So let's just listen to the music for the first section, going leading up to where the Fuete Soto diagonal starts. Just hear it first, and then we can do it once and then talk about it. So Rob, we'll just do that first section, please. Thank you. Thank you. Good. That very first step, really feel, I know you were only marking it that time, but really have a sense of give on that. Yeah, the very first step that you do. And then you've got that very funny sort of syncopated rhythm to get yourself into the ton de flesh. Don't make your preparation so big that the ton de flesh doesn't look like a jump. So try and make a smaller preparation into a bigger ton de flesh and then into the cabriole as well. Okay? Should we do it one by one?
Sure.
Should we do it one by one, that section? Leo, seeing as you're a bit more rehearsed than Teo, why don't you start? Thank you, Rob. I'd still like to see a little bit more syncopation after you've done the very first step. Yeah, so we really get the yum, bum, bum, bum. Yeah. Try and hang on to it a little bit longer. And ja-dum, ba-dum, ba-dum. That's better. Yeah. That's better. Yeah, and it just makes it a bit more interesting. Mm-hmm. Yeah, on your ton de flesh, really pick up the legs and show the développé coming out of it.
And pick up, show. Yes. Good. And nice, that effacé position, which is so gorgeous. Really show it. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Good. Teo, want to have a go? Thanks, Rob. At all. Really, again, really show that effacé coming out of the tendre de flèche.
Is it a double bent leg or is it a straight leg bent?
I think it's a double, yeah. And that'll actually give you a bit more height anyway, yeah. If you think about it. Really let, pick it up. Yes, better. That's better. And just soften the arms a little bit on the cabriole. Soft, yeah. Good. And on that landing, both of you actually have a really nice sense of vroom on the landing of the double tour. Want to try once more?
Sure.
Yeah? Leo. Leo's turn. I'm trying to be kind to them. And... yes. Show the ending. And a really nice sense of on that fifth before you release to the arabesque. Really find it. Yeah. Hup. And yes, give it a moment. Absolutely. Yeah. Breathe in.
Still.
Yeah. Teo? Thanks, Rob. And lift the leg. Relax. Good. Much better. So this lovely diagonal going upstage, the tendency is that it becomes a kind of open fouetté, and you've really got to find that square position in the air. Yeah, so really think toe in the keyhole and turn the lock. Yep. Yeah. So we get that nice switch on the fouetté. And on the balancé too, that nice kind of slightly character-like, really, on the balancé. Yep, and balancé. Good, good. On the chaînés, should we talk it through? Let's listen to the music and talk it through. So just that fouetté section, Rob, we'll just have a listen to it. Yes, thank you. How many chaînés? Are you doing three chaînés?
Yeah,
so. Ideally.
Three.
Ideally. Yeah. Afraid so. Yeah. Try and, you know, that the first chaînés, make it a little bit faster. Yeah. Think of it almost like a petit pas de basque or a soutenu going into the other two chaînés. Yeah. Leo, want to have a go? Yeah. Let me know if I'm pushing you too hard. Okay. So just eight in, thank you, Rob. All right, yes, it's the spacing as well, isn't it? I think you need to start a little bit here. The second fouetté was actually much better than the first fouetté because I really got a sense of that before you turned to the arabesque. Yeah. You've almost got to make it quite clipped in a way. And up, switch, balancé. Up, switch. That's better. That's better. Yeah. Yep. Good. Teo, want to have a go? Up, switch.
better. It's better with three. I know it's harder, I know. But then you've got to, you've got to really think about how you're going from the third chaîne into your preparation.
Yeah.
Yeah, give yourself a good preparation, keep your spot. And are you finishing, actually, you can let me know, are you going fondue and then extending? Is it like a double? Because they're, yeah, because you've almost got to anticipate it as well. Yes, five, six, seven, and yes, yeah, it's quite fast, isn't it? Try and avoid it, yeah. Just try the lame duck into the arabesque. One, two, three, and up, up, down, and a. Good, that was much better. Just be careful on your fuerte that your arm isn't here. Absolutely in front of your nose, yeah. Yes, good. Yeah, good. You had enough of that section? Try the next one. Let's do the next one, yes. This is a kind of a funny section in terms of the arms, isn't it? Let's just talk. Yes, so ideally you want your arms to be in first on the step together. And then it's up the outside and in, and down the front, up the outside and in. Yeah, and then again, yeah. And then if you think of bringing the arms to first on the preparation, I think that's the best way to think about it. Let's listen to the music and just mark the arms for the clarity. Yeah, that was quite clear. Then on this give step across the front, yeah, really, it's a real give. That's why I'm saying it's a give step, yeah? It's giving to the courtiers all around you. And then that nasty little turn out of it. Just show me where you're thinking of. So you're thinking of a fifth and a release. Okay. Okay. It should be two, yes, it should be. No, it should be two across the front. Oh, sorry, I'm knocking my microphone. It should be two across the front. Front and switch. Yeah, which I know is not very nice to do, but it looks nice. Do you want to have a go, Leo? Rest. Good.
Try not to swing it.
Yeah.
That's
the thing. Yeah. Yes. Really use that arm coming up to help you. Lift the arm. Oh, lift. Yeah. So you get that sense of up to stop yourself. Yeah. And you've kind of got to really lock in.
Yes.
Lock in to the lats. Yeah. Yeah. Teo? About there being lots of steps. There's an awful lot to fit in, which is unusual for men. It's more of, you know, girls are more used to that, but it's for men to kind of fit all these little steps in is really quite tricky. But they're doing a good job. So now, when you've, after the arabesque, really make something of this position. Yeah? Make it quite important. And up. Exactly. Yeah. And it's quite nice to have a bit of a. Yes, yeah, set yourself up for the next section. Let's talk the next section through, okay? And before you, let's just, what I want to mention is that on your plié, I want to see the plié into the floor, yeah, and the saison. not quite so big so that the next bit is bigger. Yeah, so keep it low, low, big. Yeah. Can we hear lead into the next section? Oh, sorry, Rob. That's fine. So the entrelacé has a feeling of surprise.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Let's do it. Little hitch kick at the end needs a little bit more precision.
It needs to be to the front, right?
Yes.
Yeah, otherwise
yeah.
You miss it.
Exactly. Yeah. And it's a bit of a surprise as well. Ta-tum. Yeah. So we really. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah. Yeah. Good. We might do that one again.
Yeah, yeah.
Teo, have a go. And again, you know, that very end position can have a little bit more of ba-bum, yeah, boom, boom, to finish. I know. Yeah. But after that little hitch kick, really think of putting that front foot down. Put it down so that you can then straighten. Turn down. Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Leo, have another go. Yeah, you kind of need to be really grounded at the very end. Yes, much better. Yeah, much better. Taya? Arms up quicker on the entrelacé. Getting the arms up.
Hand.
Yes. Yeah, again, yeah. Let's see the position in the air. Better. Better. And that'll pull you up. You can do the same, actually, Leo. Yeah, really. Yeah. So the whole position is airborne. It's not still getting into the air. Yes. Yeah. I think so. Yeah, I think you have to. Yes. It's a lot. What else would you do? I think you have to open both arms, yeah. Yeah, I think you have to. I think naturally that will. Anything else you want to do in that? Do you want to? Yes, from the assemblée section. Yeah, sure. Do you want to do that up to the end? Or see how you go? Yeah, see how the legs are. Yes, please.
Super.
I think you're doing a wrong arm, I'm afraid to say. After you've done the assemblé and the soda basque, just show me you finished your soda basque the first time. So the arm has to come, because you land here, and then the arm comes up the front.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I thought
you
land.
No, no.
We don't ever.
Not going into the arabesque, because it's a port de bras up the front, yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's good to know.
Yeah. Yeah. Do you want to just mark it through, just that diagonal, just for the arms? Because otherwise you're landing and you're just doing that, and you want to land and do that, which actually might help a little bit. That's it, good, yes, yes, yes. It looks more coordinated as well.
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh, so
Teo lucked out.
Would you like to? I'll go on.
No.
I'm being told you can if you want.
It's fine.
No. I think we should give them a break, don't you? They've done so well. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. Good luck with your debuts as well. Good luck, good luck. Thank you. Go and have a well-earned rest. And Sammy, if I can borrow you,
sure.
We're going to...
Yeah,
come and have a little chat. Thank you.
Nice evening.
Oh, wow. That is tiring, isn't it?
It's tough. It's really tough. And they've had the... They do an opening section. The boy does his solo. And then they have a really mean coda, which is very exciting. But at the end of it, everybody just goes, ugh.
They just... Exhausted.
Exhausted, yeah. Yes.
How very exciting for them, though.
Yeah.
Now, Sammy, you've had a very long career yourself as a former dancer with Sadler's Wells Royal Ballet and became the Birmingham Royal Ballet. Mm-hmm. And as you mentioned earlier, you've danced in many roles in Swan Lake, including Odette O'Deal, you said just now. Can you just tell us a little bit about that role? I mean, that really is one of the most challenging in the repertoire, isn't it?
It is one of, yes. I mean, I never did Aurora in Sleeping Beauty, and I hear ballerinas say that actually Aurora, in a way, is more difficult. I can't say because I didn't do it. With Swan Lake, the thing about Swan Lake is that it's so well crafted that it allows you to grow into the role. It really feels a very natural progression to go from Act 2 into Act 3 and then into the tragedy of Act 4. And it's such a... It is tough, of course, technically it's tough. Artistically, I think, is potentially even more difficult because you have to... The music is just so perfect. Mm. It couldn't be more perfect. And so I think if you just really become one with the music, it almost does the job.
You
know,
yeah.
Feeling, just embodying the music. Mm. The choreography is, I think in terms of a classical ballet, it is just so well structured that it evolves very naturally. And obviously you have to work at it. Mm. And I mean, you know, you see ballerinas in the Royal Ballet who've been doing Swan Lake for years and years and years, but they still have to rehearse it. You know, they still spend hours and hours and hours rehearsing it, finding something new. And of course, the beauty about a role like Odette O'Deal is whoever the audience comes to watch, you'll see something different every time. You know, every ballerina is different. Every ballerina has something new to offer. And even a ballerina who's repeated the role over and over again, each time they come to it, they will find something new, a different side of the story to tell, or a different element of technique to try. Mm. So it's a very special role.
And perhaps putting your own stamp on it as well.
Absolutely, as a dancer, yes, yeah. And also experiencing, you know, whoever's coaching you, I think, has a very big influence as well,
yeah,
as to how you perhaps interpret something. And that's why it's so important that you trust whoever's coaching you, because, you know, you want them to make sure that you're going to look your absolute best.
It's a real partnership, isn't it, that coaching? I mean, you can see a bit of that tonight.
Yes, a real partnership, yeah. Yes.
And what is it, do you think, that gives Swan Lake this enduring appeal? And we've talked about it has passion and tragedy and wonderful music. And thank you, Rob, again, for giving us an insight into this amazing score tonight. Could you pick one thing, or is it all of them?
It's very hard to pick. I think that the beautiful thing about a ballet like Swan Lake, it sets a standard. And it really shows the strength of a company. And Swan Lake is, it really is pure classical ballet as well as character work. And it's what you've been training for in a way, your whole life as a student. That's what your training is for, to kind of ultimately do something like Swan Lake. Mm. And it doesn't matter what role you play in Swan Lake, that the training and the technique that you're striving for is all comes to the fore in Swan Lake. You can't hide anything.
No.
Everything has to be pure classical ballet. But of course, the beauty of Swan Lake is that you've got the freedom of your arms and your port de bras for the swans. Yeah. And then of course you've got something for everybody, because the character work is fantastic. You've got a Spanish dance, a chardash, a mazurka, a Neapolitan. Yeah. So it's, there's something there for everybody.
Yeah. And the standard here at this company is top notch.
The standard is incredible. Yes. Yeah. I mean, there's some very, very special dancers here.
That's true.
Yeah.
And with dancers like the two boys we've seen tonight, they're making their debuts. What happens? What's the journey? Do they come in not knowing one step, or do you say, actually, you need to know quite a lot before you come into the studio with me?
Generally, I mean, both Leo and Teo have been obviously involved in Swan Lake now for quite a few years. So they've been watching, and you innately take things in. So even when you haven't done a role before, in a ballet like Swan Lake, you've got a fairly good idea of sort of what's expected of you, and a reasonable idea of what the steps might be. Of course, it's a whole different ball game actually putting them together and dancing them. And as Teo was saying, the stamina required is, and you can only really build that up by rehearsing. And that's why rehearsal is so important, because you have to have that slow build. You can't just get up and do it.
No.
You have to have the slow build and the understanding that it will gradually improve. So I think Leo's shows are relatively soon into the run of Swan Lake, whereas Teo isn't until kind of towards the end of the run. So he's right at the beginning of his process. So if any of you come and see his performance, hopefully you will then see the transition after having time to rehearse.
Yeah. And how do you feel? How exciting is it for you, passing on all of your experience to these young dancers?
Oh, it's amazing. I love it.
And working with the company.
Yeah. It kind of feels like you've come full circle in a way. And there is nothing nicer than passing on what you know and seeing young dancers flourish and blossom and taking on board and allowing themselves to, again, to trust what you might be saying to them so that they can then improve. And I think it's so important for dancers, doesn't matter what age you are. Even me at my ripe old age now, I'm still very curious.
Yeah.
There's so much to learn and so much to absorb and so much to observe and take in and see how else you can improve what you're giving to the dancers.
Now, we're going to see some swans soon. We couldn't really have an evening without seeing some swans. Can we just talk a bit about the corps de ballet role and another iconic moment with the corps de ballet swans?
Yes.
It's challenging again, isn't it? Just talk us through that.
Being a swan, I mean, I remember very well being a swan. And I remember at the age of 17 being a swan as a student and being absolutely terrified. I still remember that now, that I'd go wrong and that I'd get shouted at by one of the dancers who were in the corps de ballet. Being a swan is a huge responsibility, because in a way, you're part of a team. So there's a certain amount of individuality, obviously, that you can have. I mean, you know, you have your own personality, but you have to be drilled like a team. And it's that responsibility that makes it so, in a way, exciting to be part of a corps de ballet, because there is a very really sort of tactile feeling. You know when it's been a good show, because you get a sense of the girls around you, that almost you feel like you've moved as one, you breathed as one, you know, you sang as one, and it's a really special feeling when that, you know, that happens. And I must say, the corps de ballet are in a really good place right now, so I'm really excited to see them.
That's exciting. On stage. And they're foot perfect as well, aren't they? Always, whenever you come and see the corps de ballet here.
They should be.
After your fantastic rehearsing, they will be.
Yeah.
And this is a huge show to put on. It involves the whole company, I think. Pretty much, yes.
Yeah. It's a big cast. I mean, obviously, we have the cast interchange, so we always have to have a few spare people in case we have to replace somebody. And obviously, there are cast changes for a lot of the main roles. But it is pretty much, yeah, I'd say everybody in the company is involved in one way or another.
Must be quite challenging putting on such a huge production.
It is, it is. And, you know, all credit to Philip Mosley, who is the rehearsal, that he does all the scheduling, and he has a really tough job.
Yeah, I bet.
Yeah.
So when will you be going to stage rehearsals? Is that soon?
Next week.
Next week, oh God.
Yeah, next week. I think we've got 8.
Goodness.
Next week. Or so maybe 6 and then a couple the following week, because we've got the general on Tuesday and then we open.
Gosh. Not long.
So
all the repetiteurs come together then?
Yes, we all come together. So we've all been kind of rehearsing in our separate studios. And today actually was the first time we all came together for the full call this afternoon. So it was actually really nice to see, you know, to see the bigger picture in a way, everything coming together. And
do you feel a sense of responsibility? Because it's such a big ballet.
Of course, yeah. It's a big, and as I said, you know, this ballet sets a standard. And you can see the standard of a company when you watch a ballet like Swan Lake.
Yeah.
And obviously the Royal Ballet has a huge reputation of being the best company in the world.
Definitely.
And the corps de ballet is, you know, pretty hot.
Perfect. Yes. Yeah. And just one final question before we let you do your next rehearsal. We must mention the music again. It is unbelievable, isn't it? And how much do the dancers, do you think, and we can ask the dancers in a second, rely on that music to carry them through the role?
Hugely. I mean, the music is, I think, probably one of the most perfect scores for a ballet, because it just, you know, it says everything it needs to. The music tells a story. You can listen to the music and not need to see, you don't need to see the movements, because the music conjures up exactly what you need to be, what you imagine you're going to be seeing. So it's beautiful music. But it's interesting because apparently, I'm sure somebody will correct me, but when Tchaikovsky wrote the music for, I think it was originally for the Bolshoi Ballet, and Petipa did the choreography, it was not a success. Mm. And people didn't like the music and they didn't like the choreography. But after Tchaikovsky died, Rob, maybe you can correct me on this, Petipa changed the structure of the music and the structure of the choreography. And it then became a big success.
Yes, I think that's right. It's just rearranged.
Rearranged, yes. But it's also interesting, lots of companies also, you know, have musical parts in different sections.
Yeah, so it puts hairs in the back of your neck. It's that oboe, isn't it, I think, at the beginning.
Yes. Just, and, of course, you know, the Act 2 music is so beautiful.
All of it.
Haunting.
Yeah, yeah, haunting.
And
really.
Then Act 4 is so tragic. I mean, it's
it's not a happy ending, this one, is it?
No, no.
Thank you so much for talking to us. It's been an absolute delight, hasn't it? Thank you so much, Sammy. We are now going to keep you working on to the next rehearsal.
Okay.
Please, can you just tell us what we're going to see now?
So we're going to see the two swans, who are, if you like, the mainstays of the swans. They're the leaders of the swans, and they're the protectors of the swan queen. So they have a huge responsibility to make sure that the Swan Queen is safe. And that's their role. And during Act Two, they do a duet, which again is very difficult because it's jumpy, and it's sustained, and it's a waltz, and it's a kind of quite a heavy waltz. And a lot of the accents are sort of on the downbeat, which makes it for girls quite heavy to do. So what's important is that we find the right moments for there to be lift and lightness, so it's not all doom and gloom. and can I please ask the audience to, when the big swans are finished, if you come to see a performance, because we'll do it in sections today, but when you see the dance from beginning to end, please give it a big clap, because it never gets the applause it's due.
Oh, we certainly will, won't we?
Thank
definitely.
You.
Oh, thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Sammy, thank you.
Pleasure.
Onto the stage, into the studio, first artists of the Royal Ballet, Julia Roscoe and Nadia Mullover-Barley. Please join us. Thank you so much. I'll let you do your rehearsal.
Okay. Thank you. Hi, girls. And so I probably should just say as well that these two have had very little rehearsal. In fact, Nadia has had no rehearsal. So today is one of the first sort of proper rehearsals or breaking down rehearsals that they've had. So ladies, let's just, we'll break it down into sections. Let's do the first section up until you do the PK and attitude where you just cross, and then we'll stop, okay? Just speak, go easy the first time, yeah, because I know you're not warm. Try, I know the temptation is to do a huge preparation before the jeté, but what happens is we then lose the impact of the jeté. So try and keep the preparation, the step together, a little bit smaller. I mean, of course, you've got to stretch your feet so that the jeté has a bit more of a height on the jump. Yeah. Softer arms, yeah, air under your arms all the time. When you do the jeté coming forwards, really drive it forwards, yeah? Drive that front leg forwards, yeah? Then when you're coming upstage on the tenlevé, again, really, you know, so you're going out, aren't you, on the tenlevé, really direct that jeté towards each other, yeah, on that diagonal. So there's always a sense of coming together, moving apart, coming together, moving apart. So it's not, try not to be too separate. Think of yourselves as almost, you know, attached at the hip almost, yeah? And easy under the arms, everything you're doing, yeah? Try not to get, not straight arms, yeah? Lead with the elbows all the time, yeah? I think you're just a little bit late when you do the arabesque across here into this attitude meeting in the center. Just try and, it feels a little bit late because it's nice if you can get to this one a little bit sooner. Should we just listen to it? Yeah. Can we play the whole thing, Rob? Well. A little bit quicker, yeah, so that it's not down, down, up, and down, down, up, so that it's an up, dee da da, up, yeah, and then you can really hang on to that, yeah. Should we try that section once more? Okay, so don't make the gallop bigger than the jeté. Thank you, Rob. Hold.
was much better. And that one where you cross, again, just make it so that you're just crossing, so we sort of get a glimpse of both of you. It's not a complete crossing. On this one, yeah, this one, when you're in this position. Yeah, and maybe a little bit Nadia.
Past,
yes, yeah, so if you're in front of each other initially, now when you PK, you'll go past. That's it. So that we see the separation on the PK.
Okay.
Yeah? Let's play the beginning. Don't do the jumping, but pick up the arabesque, step, arabesque, and we'll carry on from there. Play it, Rob, and we'll catch you. Good ladies. My favourite section is this, the renversé section. Yeah. Julia, you can afford to hold that one. You're coming this way, aren't you? Which way did you go? It is that way. Hold just a little bit longer, and then when you bring your arms up to fifth, have a sense of reach. Yes. Yes. So it doesn't just go from here. The arms have to come through fifth. Yeah, there's actually a sense of lifting to come through. Yeah. So just let me see Nadia first, just doing this renversé section. And through, and step, and lift, and through, and up. Yeah, I'd like to leave your head a little bit longer to the front. Up, step, together. Leave head. Yes, up. Yeah, and leave, step, right. Yeah, yeah. It's so important to get that. Yeah, to you, yes, absolutely. All of that's got to be used. Julia, same thing, yeah. Really use your back. Up, step, together, lift, renversé, and up, step, together, lift, renversé. Yes, yeah, you can afford to, from here, I want to see, it is that arm you're using. You've gone up this way, haven't you? Dum, but I'm here. So from here, I want to see that through. Yeah? Up, yum, but leave, take, yes, Julia. There you go. Yep. Yes. Yeah. It should kind of feel, you know, oozy. Yeah.
When you get it, it does feel
yes,
nice.
It does feel nice. And it stops it from looking stiff. Yeah. And then when you do the arabesque facing each other, again, really have a connection on that PK. Yeah. Well, go there naturally. Don't brush it through, but don't do a rond de jambe either. It's kind of, because it has a feeling of turning, it's got to have a little sense of. I think that's too much. I think it's too straight.
Too straight.
Yeah. That's better. Yes. Yeah. Let's do that. Let's do the same. Maybe if you can play halfway through of the beginning, Rob. Play the into the yes. If we can have about how much in about
five.
Okay. Let me just check those arms, because you're not quite together. So just show me you've done your arabesque together. Carry on from there, up the side, down the front, up the front, down the front. Yes, yeah. And on each of those piques, yeah, pique, grow. Don't just make the arabesque, yeah? Make the arabesque and it grows and it steps. And it grows and it steps. And it reaches, steps. And reach, yes, Nadia, yes. Because then it feels so much nicer, yeah? So don't make it dry, yeah? Good. Why don't we carry on into the yum, dee da da, yum, ba da 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 dum? Yeah? Yeah, this section now that the girls are about to do is actually really, again, because they've got to do entrechat cease, and it's quite slow and it's quite heavy, but that's the way it is. That's, that's the choreography. Girls, do remember to show that. With the head and the arm on each développé. Yeah, don't cut it. Yeah, that's so important, again, to get that fullness of movement into the tombé. Nice square tombé, and then don't forget the underneath foot in the petit assemblé. You want to have a go? Yeah? All right, can we have a lead in, please, Rob? Before you get so tired, I get no sense of connection between the two of you. So when you're going this way, if I'm opposite you, Nadia, yeah, we're going to go this way. I want to see you. Yeah, look at each other, then to here. Yeah, and then on this one, find each other. Yeah, so that it's a sense of meeting minds. Same place, please. Good, ladies, good. So much better. Mm-hmm. So much better. It does help. You know, then you've got a connection with each other. You're kind of, you can spur each other on. You can say, come on, we can do this. We can make it. You've done your last cease, and then you've got that port de bras forwards. Don't anticipate the port de bras forwards before you've landed on 2 feet. Yeah? So you want to feel your landing. You've landed. Now a little breath. To go down, to go up. Yeah, as opposed to going down. Yeah? Should we just hear the last two? Have you got the last two? Développé, écarté, and a plié, entrechat, cease. You're going, I think, away, aren't you? On the, yes. We'll go
straight on it.
Straight on it, great, thank you. Ready? I'll give you an and. Ready? Find a breath, breath, one, lift through, lift. And let's stop. Good. All right. Nice, ladies. The first tombé pas de bourrée, you don't need to travel quite so far. Yeah? Make that a smaller distance to travel. Then you can travel. Then you can travel. And then you don't have to travel quite so far. Yeah? Really nice use of body. Yeah? But I want to see better use of feet. I want to see the toes working. Toes. Ba-dum, bum. Yeah, and each pique, I should really have a sense of that you're actually breathing in. You're not just hitting the position. Your breath is making you go
there's a feeling of, like you're almost like you're trying to fly each time, yeah? That sense of flight through the arms and through the torso. Yeah, so it's not just the arms lifting, it's the whole torso. Should we have a lead into the yambirara, into the tombe pas de bourre? Chasse glissade, that's the one. Good, good. We've got slightly different port de bras going on in the pirouette into the fondue. And I think you can either do this one and over, or you can do here and over. And I think it's what really helps you the best. You're doing that, and I think you did that. I mean, I'm not sure, but it seems like everyone does slight, as long as you're both the same. Yeah. But what's difficult is from on this one, you've still got to go up to go over. You don't have the port de bras element to do it. Why don't we look at both? Do this one first, and then do that one, and I'll tell you which looks the nicest. Or maybe the audience can tell us. Just do the last, yeah, you've done your last. And ya, ba, ba, bi, ba, dum, bum, bum. Well, that looked very nice. And let's have a look at the other one. And ya, da, da, di, ba, dum, bum. Oh, yes, but then, Julia, you do a funny thing halfway through. You were not convinced that you were going to keep the arm there. Try once more. Keep it there like a normal attitude turn with a rounded elbow and then reach into the cross. And dee da da yum, ba dum bum, bum. I think it worked, it's more successful when you both think of that one.
I think it's in my body.
It's in your body.
Like this one, but
yeah.
I mean, we can.
Yeah, let's aim for that one. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's just go through the next section. So you've landed, and really make sure that you do land. Yes, because now you should try and get, now you've got to try and get to your diagonal. But don't miss this position out before you go into the entrelacé. Yeah, okay, so you've got step. Together, step, entrelacé, step, together, entrelacé, step, point, point. Nice. And Julia, you can do a little bit more body, body on that. Yeah. So from here, because you've got that one, haven't you? And then you've changed to that way. So try and let's see the change of the body. Yeah. And you're stepping onto the left on point, aren't you? Point, point. Yeah. I think you step up, yeah. Point, point, yes. Yeah, so you can make a meal of that going over, over. Boom, boom. Yeah, a little bit more. Try and make it a bit more organic. Yadam, better, yes. But it's like you gather and you turn. Gather, turn, that's better. That's better. Okay, let's play into the entrelacés, please, Rob.
Thank you.
Your arms are quite different on the arabesques coming down the diagonal. Yeah. And I think you've got to, it's got to have a real feel. You've done your first one, then the second one. Think of it lifting under the arms. Lifting, lifting, and then stay. Yeah. So it lifts, it lifts, it lifts. And then make the last one a slightly different quality. So we get the cha, ba-dum. Yeah? Just try and have a sense of matching each other. Maybe if you think, so you've got your first one, haven't you, here. So then we go to like a demi-bras almost. Then you're coming slightly, probably, shoulder height, maybe a little bit higher. Then to the position, I'd get to the position, and then to the position again. Yeah. Four and five. Yes, so that fifth one is with the head straight to the... So you've got head straight, head turn, head turn, head turn, head straight. Yeah. Just after you've done your arabesques, before you do the piques, coming back. So again, keep them growing the whole time. Yeah, don't let it be and yeah, and up. Yes, all the time they're your wings. Yeah, all the time. Let's listen to the entrelacés. Don't do them, and we'll pick it up from there. So just go straight into the entrelacés. Thank you, Rob.
Flat.
Yes.
Okay.
So you need to come forward and you need to hold back a little bit so that you finish flat.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Heads on the petit bat. Show me the PK petit battement step, because so you've got to do a little bit more head turning. You're completely staying this way, and Nadia is doing a little bit of a head, which I think you're not meant to. I'm going to say it looks quite nice.
As each couple decides.
Okay. Let's see them without. Just show me without. Keeping. And keep, lift, and through. Yeah, maybe that's fine, actually. Maybe that's fine, because then it's nice to have that coming out of it. Yeah. You can work on it. Yeah. Let's do the whole thing from the entrelacés.
Yes.
To the end. I'm not going to make you do the... No, I'm not going to make you do the whole thing. one little note for you on the entrelacés. I'd like you to hold your arms a little bit longer in fifth and slow them down as you land. Don't land. Yeah? Delay the landing with the arms. That's it, because it'll soften the landing. It'll feel not as heavy. Okay. Don't get too circular with the arms, yeah? Maybe it's better for you to think of that as opposed to that. Yum, bum, bum, bum. Yeah, and think about using that part of your arm a bit more. Yes, yes, yeah.
We can work on it. We can work on it. What it's this part of your arm is so important in swans. Yeah, you've got to kind of really feel under this part. That's so it doesn't. It's not the fingers. Yeah, it's just happening. And be careful that you don't break the wrists. Yeah, it's just coming. We'll work on it. We'll work on it. Should we do a little bit of act four?
Yeah?
Okay. Yeah, good. Just a nice gentle finish. So Rob, we're going from the little da 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 dee dum yum da lum bum. So we can go from this position. Thank you. Let's stop a second. So, no, it's a normal arabesque. Yeah, normal. Yeah, and this one, the head is up. Yeah, head is up. Remember what I said the other day about arabesque arms? Remember Madam's quote that I gave you? Madam's quote was that imagine there's a little bird here and you watch it fly away. Mm. And it's so true, because when we get that arabesque, it doesn't mean anything. It really doesn't. You've got to have that connection with the eyes. You're creating a line with your nose, with your eyes, and with your fingers. And it's really important. Yeah? So it's a normal arabesque, and then to here. Up, up, lift, pas de bourrée. Yeah? Nadia hasn't done this at all, so they quickly learnt it before. Same place, please, Rob. Soft arms. Head front. Lift. Just sort out those arms. Good, not bad at all. This part of Act Four is the lament, so it's very sad. The swans are very sad because Odette has been let down in a way, because Odile has come in and made the prince agree to marry Odile, and so Odette is now destined to remain a swan. So, and all her swans and her sort of leaders of the swans are very sad. So this is, it has a very kind of melancholy feel. Head is to the front, Nadia, on the attitude. Front, yeah. Front and up, pas de bourrée. Breath, and be careful this isn't just it's not just the arms. Yeah, it has through your body, breathe it. Yeah, breathe. Yes, exactly. It makes a difference. Yeah, it drives it in a different way. Then the attitude, show me your attitude turn. And up through. So that releve, your eyes are down. Just carry on from there because I want to check your arms. There. And so you have to be careful here, yes, that you don't get too close. So that's a kind of tricky thing. If anything, I guess should really be, if anyone's going to be in front, it should be the left person, left in front of right. But you could be a little bit further away from each other. Just carry on from there. You've done this arabesque. And let's really see this position. I know it's a funny position. It's that kind of open arabesque. But really lean onto it. Then you've got the little limp. Yeah. Yes. So I'm going to double check these arms because the original arms came up to fifth and down into the allongé. From here, yeah, they came. Which leg are you on? You're on.
This.
you've done yum pum, ya da dum.
It was originally this way
into the allongé. Into the open fifth. Yeah. But I know now everyone seems to be doing just one arm. Yeah. So I think let's double check it. But for now, do one arm. And then, because I think the majority are doing that. But you've done your limp. So this arm comes. So keep this arm up. This arm comes down. This arm stays in fifth, like open fifth. And this arm joins. Yep. So it's a little bit simpler, but then you can both be the same, because at the moment you both look quite different. Just mark it through for me. So you've done your arabesque and your limp, and releve round. Yeah, it's still not quite the same. Yes, and it should be as well. It's a... oh, is that me? Up fifth. Up, yeah, not too high though, Nadia, just really low. And fifth and up, yeah. So the arm comes through and up. Through and up, yeah. Let's try from the beginning again, that section. We got time? Yes, okay.
Thank you so much. If you'd like to get some water, quick glug of water. Wasn't that beautiful? Oh my goodness me.
Yeah,
and that music.
You know,
just...
They're looking pretty good already, so.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think they're going to be a fine pair of swans when they get to perform.
And you were saying that Nadia hasn't actually had much rehearsal time.
No, nothing. Really.
Wow.
Because Nadia is also a swan and a side swan, as is Julia. So they do three roles in swans.
Goodness.
So that's a bit of a headache in itself, isn't it?
Can you all move forward a tiny bit? Just out of the light, that'd be great. I'll pass you some mics. Thank you for that. That was absolutely beautiful. How challenging is this role? I mean, again, we've talked about it all night. It looks hard, but beautiful.
Jumping, I think, in point shoes, that's especially hard. It's kind of like a male variation, but in point shoes. So, yeah, it requires a lot of stamina and rehearsal.
Doing the, like, putting the whole of the dance together is actually, like, really tiring. Mm. Like, section by section, it is tiring, but it's kind of more manageable. And then when you put it all together by the end, it's like, you know, you're really digging deep to push for that last jeté.
Yes.
So, yeah.
You've danced this role before, haven't you, Julia?
Yes.
Nadia, this is your debut.
Yes.
Congratulations, exciting. Yeah. How are you feeling?
Yeah, good, yeah. It's like a lot of things to watch out for. As you said, we're both core swans, side swans and big swans, so it's a lot to learn and kind of look out in rehearsals. When you're doing one role, you kind of have to have an eye out for the other two roles. So it's a lot to think about.
And how do you keep up that stamina? I mean, it's a long run. It's coming in spring, back again in summer. Mm. Any tips, Sammy?
Just rehearsal.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, you have to get into the studio and you have to do it from beginning to end. So once it's in their bodies and once it's been refined, then they have to start pushing. Even if they're feeling tired, they've got to start pushing, because otherwise, that's the only way you can increase your stamina by getting tired and then pushing past that tiredness.
Well, we wish you all the luck in your debut, in all of your performances and runs. Thank you so much for a really beautiful rehearsal, for two rehearsals from you, Sammy. Thank you so much. Nadia and Julia, thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. You can give me that. Thank you. Thanks, Sammy. Oh, what a wonderful evening it has been. And I'd just like to say thank you also to Head of Music, Rob Clark, who's been playing for us this evening. What a treat. Well, that is it for tonight's Insight, I'm afraid. But you can see Swan Lake on the main stage here at the Royal Opera House from the 6th of March. Please visit the website for tickets or join us live in the cinema on the 24th of April or for an encore screening on the 28th of April. Well, thank you once again to all of our guests this evening. Thank you to our audience here in the Claw studio and to all of you watching around the world. We hope you've had a lovely insight. Good night.